Rhode Island's second in charge is continuing her push for more affordable housing.
This afternoon, Lieutenant Governor Sabina Matos hosted a virtual summit. The topic, how to remedy the housing shortage and address homelessness in the state.
New at 6, 12 News reporter Chelsea Jones shares personal testimony from those who experienced homelessness and the steps being proposed to solve it.
Lieutenant Governor Sabina Matos and others say that many of the problems highlighted today show that there is an issue with access, availability, and money.
As of this January, more than 1,200 people experienced homelessness. The pandemic made matters worse.
Systemic racism, exacerbated by the pandemics in our increased eviction rates, weak and inconsistent eviction and foreclosure protections, this has perpetuated homelessness.
Those who know what it's like personally range in experiences.
I know what it is to sleep in doorways. I know what it is to be out there on the street. I know what it is to be homeless and sleeping in the rain and in the snow.
Some even came to Rhode Island seeking refuge from abuse, but made too much money to get assistance.
I was chosen off of the Section 8 wait list. I want to say 3 times as of date. And all 3 times I was denied because I was considered to be over income.
Others lost everything in a fire twice, but believe the way to fix this is...
We need housing. We need housing.
During this year's legislative session, lawmakers were able to secure items in the state budget, like a deputy secretary for housing. They've also been able to dismantle restrictive laws that played into housing discrimination.
If a landlord didn't like that you had a housing choice voucher with what was frequently called Section 8, they could refuse to rent to you. That is no longer true. Landlords could also refuse to rent to you if you were a member of the LGBTQ+ community. That is also no longer allowed.
But there's still a lot of work to be done, which is why these stakeholders gathered Wednesday. They say systemic changes are needed. They believe things like creating short-term living options for those still rebounding from the pandemic will help, along with continuing to build affordable housing for those on all sides of the pay scale, plus making sure that eligibility is flexible for people that are applying for housing.
Another big issue that policy analyst Christina Fox says is that people need $66,000 to rent a 2-bedroom apartment in Rhode Island, but the problem is the average renter only makes $34,000, which basically makes it all cost prohibitive. I'm Chelsea Jones, 12 News.